yet again for the score, grabbing Harding along with him into the end zone.
Tulsa will go for the 2 points to try to get on top 14 to nothing, where it would take two touchdowns and the Cowboys going for two if they get on the scoreboard to win it. They'll work from the middle of the field. Wants to throw, he's in trouble. He's got a man wide open in the end zone and overthrows Michael Gunner. So the Golden Hurricane had the opportunity to make it 14 to nothing. And Skip Ash just a little too strong when he pulled the trigger. John, you think there's some people here shocked tonight?
I know there are some players in white jerseys on the far sidelines that are shocked, as well as their fans, but Tulsa's been very impressive. They had some breaks, but a lot of them they've made themselves. The interceptions and the blocked field goal attempt. Here's Ast again. Stays in the pocket, gets hit, delivers a pretty good ball. Looked like Gunter might have jumped a little bit early, but it would have been a tough catch. Good pressure by the Oklahoma State defense.
The Cowboy offense, the last series, we saw Ike Jackson at the reins. The kicking team on the field. Steve Crum, the last time he kicked off, it was a short kick. I don't know if it was intentional or not.
Cowboys hoping to get something going. They got a break several minutes ago after a TU fumble inside the Tulsa 40-yard line, but were unable to get any points on the board.
Big for OSU will be speedsters Harry Roberts, James Evans, and Kenny Zachary. OSU still looking for the big play. Crum's kick's going to be a dandy. Evans takes it 8 yards deep. He'll down it there, and OSU will go to work at their own 20. The Cowboys have a minute and 44 to get on the scoreboard. Ike Jackson will be the quarterback. 12 to nothing, Tulsa leading OSU. Ray Tucker along with John Fossen at Scali Stadium. Great night for college football, especially if you're a TU fan. It's been an exceptionally long half for OSU fans. Each team with three timeouts remaining. Tulsa now with two as they call a timeout. They want to talk things over. Two or three players come over, and Ike Jackson and Jimmy Johnson will talk it over.
Can't really figure out why Tulsa would call a timeout, Ray, except perhaps to remind the defensive backs and the linebackers to watch the long pass, because that's who the TU coaches are talking to right now on the other side of the field. You're watching Jimmy Johnson talking to Ike Jackson. Blake Borkman, TU linebacker, trots back. That's Jackson right there, the sophomore.
Jackson relieving Adam Hines, who started at quarterback tonight for OSU. He had his problems. This is Jackson's second or third series. Neither quarterback has moved the offense. First and 10 from the OSU 20. They'll give it to Anderson up the middle. Oh, what a hit. Blake Bjorkman, who made the interception and a long return earlier in the half, made the stop on Ernest Anderson.
You can see how fired up that Hurricane defense is, and the whole team. They've got the momentum, that's for sure.
I'm trying to figure out how this TU ball club could lose 38 to nothing to anybody. Of course, Arkansas ranked ninth in the country. There were a lot of OSU fans who felt their ball club should have been ranked this past week. Clock continues to run, 107 remaining in the half. Jackson to throw. He's going to go deep. He's got James Evans out there. The ball is deflected at the last moment. Jesse Morrow made the big play.
He was lucky that ball was underthrown because Evans was open.
Evans had to stop and try to come back to the football, turn his back, John.
Yep, you can see it right there. He had him beat in between the cornerback and the safety. If the ball would have been just a couple of yards longer, OSU would be in great shape.
That play took only 7 seconds. It is third and a long eight for the Cowpokes. They'd like to pick up a first down here to keep the football. They'll give it to Anderson straight up the middle with plenty of running room. He has the first down and more. Tulsa willing to give OSU that play, but not the long gainer. Albert Myers on the stop. The clock continues to run now, 45, 44. Cowboys would like to get into range for Larry Roach. He can be effective from 50 yards, hasn't been tonight. Jackson back in the pocket. He's in trouble now. Drops it over the middle, overthrows Chesley. The ball almost intercepted by Nate Harris.
He had Ernest Anderson open on the left side, a little flare pass, but chose to go deep and just threw it over the head of John Chesley, and that'll stop the clock with 29 seconds left.
The Cowboys got the first down that they needed on the previous play. They don't need the 5-6, 10-yard gainer right now. They need a pickup of 30, 40 yards to get in field goal territory. Jackson over the middle. It is complete to the 49-yard line.
Looked like Mark Cromer. It was number 87 on the catch, the senior from Broken Arrow, and the Cowboys quickly call a timeout.
OSU with two timeouts remaining. We'll take another look at it. That's the view that the linebackers, the interior line, has. Jackson with plenty of room, throws it right over the middle. Right on the money. Mark Cromer made the catch. Joe Blankenship on the stop from the defensive end spot.
Pass had to be thrown pretty well because John Cooper was just about a half step behind Cromer, and Jackson laid it in there real nice.
Cromer, two catches, 33 yards tonight. One more like that, and the Cowpokes could be in field goal range. Larry Roach has missed one tonight. I guess I should say two. He had another one blocked and returned deep into OSU territory. That resulted in a only touchdown of the ball game. Tulsa leading 12 to nothing on two Stu Crum field goals. A touchdown by Ken Lacey. The Hurricane went for two and failed. It's been a long first half for OSU fans. Only 20 seconds remaining. They'll come out of the eye with Ernest Anderson, the deep man. Jackson looks. Down and out is complete to Mark Cromer. They say incomplete.
That might be better because that'll stop the clock if it is, and it is incomplete.
The Cowboys still have two first downs remaining. They are looking for the yardage. Seconds showing on the scoreboard clock. Tulsa going with a three-man rush. Boy, that makes it tough to throw the football. Jackson will roll to his right.
Run it.
He's got a man wide open. It is Evans at the 30-yard line, down to the 27, 4 seconds. And the clock's going to stop there, and you can bet OSU will go for the field goal.
Of course, if you got a man open, throw it. He had either one that time.
I know what you were concerned about, John Fossen, and that's the time remaining on the clock.
Clock has stopped with 4 seconds to go. OSU calling a timeout. Ike Jackson, who's looked very good tonight since taking over for Adam Hines, hitting Jim Evans. That's Cowboy first down. They will try the field goal now. Ball is at the 27. Let's add 7. That's 34, about a 44-yard attempt. That's what it's going to be.
Larry Roach from 44 yards will get the call for the Cowpokes.
Interesting, Ray, that TU now has called a timeout. They're going to let Larry think about it a little bit.
Hey, Roach is only a sophomore, but he's a veteran of the football wars. He won about two or three games a year ago for the Cowboys in the closing seconds, and that's what the case will be here. The game is not at stake, but OSU definitely would like to get on the scoreboard. They trail 12 to nothing. Ike Jackson, 2 of 6, 27 yards tonight.
I'm sure Tulsa head coach John Cooper wants Larry Roach to think about missing his first field goal attempt, which sailed underneath the crossbar, missed it badly, just mishit it. And the last time he tried to boot one, it was blocked by the Hurricane. So Larry will have time to think about that.
Adam Hines will hold. Roach will attempt a 44-yarder. He did not have good rhythm on the last kick. This kick is up. It is also no good. Larry Roach did not hit that one well either. And time has expired here at Scully Stadium. The first half, our halftime score is the Golden Hurricane 12, the Cowboys nothing. We come back at halftime. We'll take a look at the OSU weight room and visit with head coach Jimmy Johnson.
And mostly during the season.
Yards, the trails on the scoreboard, of course, those, the interceptions and the turnovers hurt Oklahoma State. Take a look at Oklahoma State first and see how the Cowboys did. They had 9 first downs, 74 yards rushing on 18 attempts, 78 yards through the air. Cowboy passers Adam Hines and Ike Jackson, 7 of 16, but 2 costly interceptions, one leading to a touchdown. Cowboys fumbled once but retained possession and were hurt by 5 penalties for a total of 35 yards. Their leading rushers, Ernest Anderson, 76 yards on 16 carries. His average of 4.8 tonight. For Tulsa, 8 first downs, 67 rushing yards as opposed to the Cowboys, 74, only 21 yards through the air. 95 yards on returns, which helped. Passing, 3 passes for a total of 8 yards. 3 fumbles by Tulsa, 2 which they lost. Penalized one time for a total of 15 yards. So a rave difference has really been in those turnovers. TU was not only able to stop OSU drives, but return the ball down the field quite a ways to set up scores.
OSU has the option to start the second half as to whether or not they will receive or kick off. I'm sure they will receive the football, and we'll be back with the second half kickoff after this. Ray Tucker along with John Fossen back at Scully Stadium. Surprising halftime score. TU leading the OSU Cowboys by a score of 12 to nothing. You hear some jeers in the background, and that is for the officiating team. Tulsa has just been penalized for delay of game to start the second half. I guess the halftime show, John, a little bit too long. So the Cowboys have won the cost of the coin. Really no toss of the coin. They get the option. They'll receive from the south end of the field. And the TU players are waving down on the field for the fans to come to their feet, and where Stu Crum is set to start the second half. Roberts, Zachary, and Evans are back deep for the Cowfolks.
Very important time now for the OSU offense. Get something going early in the second half.
It's going to be a short kick taken by OSU back across the 30. Oh, what a hit by TU, and they are still fired up, and we'll find out what the OSU offense is made of as we start the second half.
Tony Buford, number 41, trotting off the field with that good hit. OSU Cowboys taking over on their own 30-yard line.
Unsportsmanlike conduct, the call against TU for the delay. Adam Hines will start the second half at quarterback. He gives to Ernest Anderson. Anderson across the 35 to the 36. He's been the workhorse for OSU tonight. He hasn't had that long gainer that he would like to have. He had one last week, 74 yards, picked up 220 yards in the season opener. It's nowhere near that tonight.
Ernest only needs, well, I say only, 123 yards tonight, which is quite a bit. That would put him 10th on the all-time career rushing list at OSU. He had over 70 yards in the first half.
Double wide receivers to the near side of the field. Anderson gets the call again, doesn't get the first down, although he does pick up 2 or 3 yards. He'll be short of it by about 2. Give a lot of credit to the Tulsa defense. Boy, have they been fired up tonight. Kevin Lilly on the stop there. He's joined by Joe Blankenship, Ryan Bruner, Mike Womack, Tom Baldwin, James Dunlap, Carl Pendleton. Right off the bat, the Cowboys faced with an important third down play. The ball at their own 37, third and 3. Fromer split wide to the right. Anderson with a call straight up the middle. He's got running room. Ernest Anderson almost broke it all the way. He is into TU territory and going to be dropped at the Tulsa 45-yard line. Robert Estes with a stop.
Ernest Anderson, one of his better long gainers of the night so far, right up the middle. Some great blocking by that Cowboy line. A miss right there. Finally, Robert Estes grabbing him around the knees, or else Ernest would have been gone.
Anderson, 19 carries, 101 yards. On the bootleg, it's Hines across the 45. He's going to be knocked out of bounds at the 40-yard line, driven into the OSU bench. There's a bootleg that John pointed out in the first half that the Cowboys do like to run. Estes once again comes up out of the secondary to make the stop.
That's a very good play, especially when you have a back like Anderson, who is such a threat and carries the ball so much. You know that the defense will be keying on him. Fake the handoff or the pitch to him and go the opposite way. Haven't seen OSU run a reverse with Anderson, but that would be a good play too, especially with a fellow like Terry Young carrying the football.
I've seen it in practice, John. It's in the playbook, second and five. Anderson gets the call and he picks up one, maybe two. Tom Baldwin out of Lansing, Illinois, made the stop, 6'4", 235, a junior, both of these ball clubs. The starting lineup dotted with sophomores and juniors. They'll be heard from in the future.
Perhaps a future quarterback right there, maybe. Looks like she's got a pretty good arm. Homecoming here at Tulsa.
Third and three for the Cowpokes. Hines wants to throw it. He does. It is complete to Terry Young. Young down to the 25.
Great move by Young to spin away from the initial hit and pick up some extra yards. That'll be a Cowboy first down. Finally shoved out of bounds at the far sideline. Adam Hines, who suffered two interceptions in the first half, cranks it up, hits Young, and it just looks like a quick out pattern. Got away from number 32, Robert Estes. It's finally number 9, John Cooper, along with number 57, Cliff Abbott, to force him out of bounds.
First down, Cowboys at the TU 26. Ernest Anderson over the right side, blocking up front. Paul Spate, Russell Graham, Doug Freeman, Kevin Igo, John Sigelski. Mark Cromer on the sidelines will bring in a play from Jimmy Johnson as the Cowboys are on the move to open the second half. Blankenship got credit for the tackle for Tulsa. They lead 12 to nothing. A chance to visit with a couple of Cowboy assistant coaches. They said, we'll find out here in the second half what we're made of. Indeed, we will. Cromer will come wide to the near side of the field, the wide side. Cromer will be the flanker, the man in the slot. Out of the eye, the Cowboys on second and seven. Quick pitch to Anderson. Anderson across the 30, make that the 20, barrels his way maybe down to the 19-yard line. See where they mark his forward progress. Defensive end James Dunlap on the stop. Little guy, 6'3", 242.
Brad Hanna getting set to come back in with a play from Jimmy Johnson.
This is the third big third down play for the Cowboys in this drive. It started back at their own 30. As Tulsa was penalized on the opening kickoff for unsportsmanlike conduct. The crowd comes to its feet. A long third and five. Hines the quarterback. The give is to Anderson, right side. He did not get the first down. We'll see if OSU chooses to go for it. Their kicking game has been a problem tonight. Kevin Igo points to the bench and says, Coach, we like about a foot and a half. Another look at it.
Bread and butter man for the Cowboys, Ernest Anderson, straight ahead. Tough to bring this fellow down. As you can see, he actually fumbled the football. Looked like it and was able to grab it back.
The last big third down play for the Cowboys, third and three. They went to the air. And Terry Young, Anderson, 20 carries, 111 yards on the night. This could be the biggest yard of the ball game for Anderson if he gets the call. Fourth and one. Anderson with a first down. Down to about the 12. Jesse Morrow made the stop. The Cowboys, John, have fooled TU a couple of times tonight on short yardage. They've gone outside the tackle spot.
Well, that time it looked like Anderson just following the block of Cook was able to pick up the yardage for the first down. He will be a tired young man by the end of this ball game, that's for sure. 20 carries already.
Oklahoma State on the march. The ball on the Tulsa 12, 9:56 left in the third period. Hines to throw over the middle for John Chesley. Lobs it up. Touchdown, Cowboys!
Nice touch by Adam Hines, 12 yards to big John Chesley, who had kind of a rough night so far, but that ought to fire the Cowboys up.
Oklahoma State on the initial possession of the first half. Get on the scoreboard. Larry Roach is on for the all-important extra point here. That cuts it 12-6.
You can see how important it was that TU missed that two-point conversion because they only have 12 now.
Morrow was defending on the play. He's only 6 foot. Roach's kick is up and is good. Chesley at 6'5" won the battle. So our score with 9:50 remaining in the third period is Tulsa 12, Oklahoma State 7. We've got a ball game on our hands. We'll be back with more from Skelly Stadium after this. Things are really rocking at TU Skelly Stadium. Oklahoma State has scored to open the second half, and they trail 12-7. The crowd on its feet for the second half kickoff, the first kickoff by Godfrey of Oklahoma State.
Another look at it. Adam Hines faking to Anderson. Just lost it up in the air. John Chesley at 6'5". Quite a height advantage over the TU secondary and gathers it in. And the Cowboys are back in this thing. 70 yards on that drive. Taking up 4 minutes and 10 seconds. Excuse me, 5 minutes and 10 seconds.
Chesley, 6'5", 230-pound junior. Made the catch. Kevin Godfrey will tee it up for the Cowpokes. As the crowd has become very active at Skelly Stadium. Not that they hadn't been all night long, but this is a battle. We've had tempers flare several times, so you know it's a pretty good rivalry between these two teams as Godfrey approaches the football. He drills it long and deep in and out of the end zone, and Tulsa will go to work first down at their own 20. And we'll find out what the Cowboy defense is made out of now. They should be sky high. We've got a great second half lined up for you. 9:50 remaining, our score. Tulsa 12, OSU 7.
Last time Tulsa defeated Oklahoma State was right here at Skelly Stadium. That was in 1964, and that was back when Skelly seated only 17,000. TU won big, 64-14.
Skip asks the quarterback. Kerry Woods, a man in motion. Long count. Handoff, Lacey, first man through. Spins off one would-be tackler, picks up baby three.
Like Harding might have gotten a hand on him, and he finally ended up picking up about a yard and a half.
One might say that TU won the battle in the trenches the first half. They were fired up and really took it to the Cowboys. OSU taking nothing away from Tulsa, might have been just a little bit flat. TU a very impressive ball club. Here's a reverse. The Cowboys smell it out.
Number 47, Brett Guy was right there. That's pretty good play call, though, Ray. That Oklahoma State defense fired up. Of course, Gunner a threat with a football, but did not fool Brett Guy at all. That was a great play. He stayed home and read it all the way.
Gary Woods with outstanding speed. He was converted from a running back spot, made into a wide receiver back in the fall. But Brett Guy made the big stop for OSU. It is now third down and 20 from deep in TU territory, back at the 11. Ast wants to throw. He's going deep. Just beyond the reach of Kirk Phillips, and the Cowboy defense is held.
Right quarterback Greg Hill, number 11, with good coverage. And the Oklahoma State Cowboys will get the football.
Gutsy call by John Cooper, going for broke back there, John. Steve Cook to punt for what I believe is the first time tonight. He averages 40.9 on the year. As long as it's 50 yards, he'll kick it from his own end zone. Stanley Blair in traffic, fair catches, and the Cowpokes take over with great field position at the Tulsa 40-yard line. Only a 30-yard punt.
Cowboys with great field position as their fans urge their team on.
12-7, TU on top of OSU. It has really been strange. Tulsa scored the first time they had the football in the first period. the first time they had the football in the second quarter, and OSU scored the first time they had the football in the third period. 8 minutes, 27 seconds remaining. John, we were wondering if the OSU defense could do the job, and they rose to the occasion.
They certainly did. They had to play a lot of football in that first half. Tulsa taking advantage of some turnovers and creating their own breaks, really. A pass interception, blocked field goal. Both of those were returned for about 40, 50 yards apiece to set up TU scores, but it has been all OSU so far early in the second half. 8 minutes, 27 seconds left to go in the third quarter.
Ray Tucker along with John Fossen. We'd like to take this time to remind you, you can join us after every Cowboy ball game. Same day delayed telecast. 10:30 in the evenings. OSU with a great future in front of them. Jimmy Johnson, their head coach. In the 4 years he's been there, the Cowpokes are 18-16-1. They opened the season with an impressive 27-6 win over North Texas State. Next Saturday night, we will be on the road playing in Louisville against the Cardinals. You can catch that game at 10:35 Tulsa time.
First down for the Cowboys on the Tulsa 40-yard line.
First and 10, OSU. Hines goes to work at quarterback, wants to throw. Has a man in the open, John Chesley. Picks up a block from Terry Young. And Ches is knocked out of bounds at the TU 25. The Cowpokes have opened it up. Jesse Morrow on the stop. John, did you see Terry Young come back and throw that block?
Threw a nice block. We might see it here. Adam Hines with plenty of time. Chesley wide open, has the linebacker beaten. We won't see the player. It is right there. In fact, it almost looked like a clip from that angle, but good effort by Terry Young. First down, Cowboys.
Cowpokes knocking on the Golden Hurricane door again from the near hash mark. Hines rolls right, wants to throw, gets some pressure, has a man wide open. The pass is complete. However, there is a flag on the play.
Thought he might have trapped it there. They're going to call it incomplete, and there was a flag on the play. We'll wait and see.
They are talking with the Golden Hurricane, so the penalty apparently is going to be against OSU. It'll be 5 yards in motion. This reminder, OSU Cowboy football is presented under the authority of the National Collegiate Athletic Association and Oklahoma State University. This delayed telecast is a copyright presentation of K2L Incorporated and was presented solely for the entertainment of our viewing audience. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of the video or audio accounts of this event without the express written consent of K2L-TV or Oklahoma State University is strictly prohibited.
Penalties hurting OSU in the first half. Total of 35 yards in penalties. This is the first one in the second half.
That sets the Cowboys back five. It'll be first and 15 from the 30. Hines, play action. Screen back to the near side. And Kelly Cook can't hang on to the football. Gosh, he had a wall in front of him.
He did. That play was well set up by the OSU offense with the exception of the catch.
In defense of Cook, it might have been just a little bit underthrown. He had to bend down for it.
Kelly still should have caught it, though, and he did have a lot of white shirts out in front of him.
Hines, numbers on the night, 8 of 15, 79 yards, two interceptions. Second and 15. Anderson gets the pitch, sweeps the right side. He's going to be tripped up. Ernest Anderson, student body right. Somebody was able to get through. Brent Dennis upended Anderson.
Looked like Dennis, number 15, forced the play. Actually kind of upset Cook, who in turn tripped up Anderson, but a good play by Brent Dennis.
A critical third and 14. For the Cowboys. Hines back paddles. He's under pressure.
That's a flag. Should be a flag.
Should be interference, and we don't see a flag, and the OSU coaching staff is upset.
I don't believe it.
If we get another look at it, John, the ball was in the air, and somebody belted the intended receiver coming down the sideline.
Ernest Anderson had the defensive man beaten over there, and he just shoved it when the ball was up in the air. And the official was right there and saw it, being objective about it now. And saying that it was a bad call, and the official was right there. That was a bad.
Larry Roach on for a 45-yard field goal attempt. The kick is up. It is no good. Wide left. And the Tulsa defense rises to the occasion. And I'm sure the OSU coaching staff still upset on the sideline. That was costly play. It would have been an automatic first down for the Cowboys.
It's too bad we can't see a replay of that, but it was pretty obvious from here.
We'll keep track of that for you. That'll be one of the key plays in this ball game, but you can't go back and get that one. It'll be up to the Cowboy defense to stop the hurricane cold here if they can. 7:16 left in the third period, plenty of time, but the Cowboys wanted to have an opportunity to get the lead, and Larry Roach has had a horrible night, John Fawcett.
Well, at least he got this one up over the crossbar, but just a little bit off to the left. That's encouraging anyway. Larry's an excellent kicker, but everybody, once in a while, has a bad night. And let's hope he comes out of it.
Pardon me, I saw Stu Crum have the same kind of night, and he's an All-American candidate also, along with Larry Roach, two of the premier kickers in the country, we should add. The football belongs to Tulsa. They'll put it into play first down at their own 28-yard line when we get back to action here. Good look at the crowd, better than 35,000 on hand tonight. We could have not asked for a better night for college football. It rained off and on throughout much of the afternoon as the crowd really getting into the ball game. But the playing surface in great shape. This is a good rug down on the field. I don't know how old it is. You can see the yellow lines marked out there. That is for professional soccer here in Tulsa. I find it a bit confusing when the ball gets inside the 15. Hopefully the players won't. So the Cowboy offense did its job, but did not come up with the points they needed. So now the defense has their work cut out for them. John, let's take another look.
It's Larry Roach walking off the field. Maybe we'll see that push against Ernest Anderson a little later on.
Tulsa shifts the tight end. They'll run to the strong side. Ken Lacy on the carry. Mike Kroll talks over things, the defensive strategy for the Golden Hurricane. As OSU has come out in the second half and been able to move the football.
Brett Guy on the stop for the Oklahoma State defense.
Lacy picked up two. Second down and 8, the ball in the middle of the field. Skip asked the quarterback. Gives to the first man through, Ken Lacy. He's got running room, lots of it in the first down.
Guy in low on the tackle, but it is a Tulsa first down. This is an important series for the Tulsa offense, important for the OSU defense. Good cutback there by Lacy. And he's able to get the first down, finally tackled in the secondary.
First down at the 40. Skip Ast has done an outstanding job running the TU offense tonight. Lacy 52 yards on 10 carries. Woods in motion. The gives to Lacy again. He picks up 2-3 at the most. The going tough up the middle. Tulsa 1-1 on the year. A win over Air Force. They were shut out by Arkansas. TU 1-0 on the year. 27-6 opening win over North Texas State. They've got their work cut out for them here. They trail 12-7, 5:47 remaining, third period action. Second and 7 for the Golden Hurricane. Ass wants to pass, rolling right. He's going to be hit. By the time he delivered it, he completed it, though, out in the flat to Lacy, and he is very close to the first down. It depends on where they spot the football. Lacy came into the ball game, 28 carries, 126 yards, averaging 4.3 yards per carry.
Ast is sure staying in the pocket under a lot of pressure. Good pass that time to Lacy. Both Lacy and Gunter are fairly good receivers. Not only good runners, but they can catch the football, and a pretty good tandem to have in the backfield.
Here's a big play for you. 3rd and 1 at midfield for the Golden Hurricane. Long count. Ast is going to be hit, and he is very close to the first down. It will just depend again upon his forward progress as to where they spot it.
I think he might have gotten it, but it will be awfully close. The official's foot is about as close to that 50-yard line as you can get.
Here's another look at it. Nothing fancy. Ast on the option play. It's a battle between he and Mike Green.
The determination of Skip Ast might have enabled Tulsa to get that first down, and it did.
Skip Ast got it by about 6 inches. A big first down for the Golden Hurricane. They would love to get out and get more points on the board. Love the scoreboard here, John. First down, it's not hard to miss that. Phillips. Wide to the left side, Gary Woods in motion. Ast, option play, he's going to be dropped for loss in the backfield.
It's kind of play the OSU defense needs. Get Tulsa in a second and long situation here. Gary Lewis in there, Harding also. Skip Ast turned around and not much room to go. You can see Tim Reeves really stacked it up, number 64, down at the bottom of the pile. He made the play, good penetration, and Ast really had nowhere to go.
A loss of a yard on the play. It'll be second down and 11 as Ast looks over the OSU defense. 4:08 remaining. Ast rolling left, throws. He's got a man open, and let's see if they say it's complete or not. I was watching the official. Johnny started to wave his arms like it was incomplete. Of course, a little indecision on his behalf. They say it was complete, so it's going to be shy of the first down by about a yard. So another big third down play. Kirk Phillips on the receiving end. Let's see if he caught it.
Looks like he might have had it. Officials say he did. That's just about a yard shy of the first down. OSU tried to blitz that time, but Ast got rid of it.
Third and one. Woods in motion. Give us to Lacey straight ahead. He's got the first down. Down to the Cowboy 38 as the Tulsa offense comes roaring back.
Another look at it. Lacey right up the middle. Sure is nice to have two fellows with the speed and the power that both Gunter and Lacey have, because you can't key on one man like you might be able to against the OSU Cowboys. Anderson will carry the ball more times than Cook, but Lacey gives them to you an added advantage.
An important series for the Golden Hurricane. Ast, play action, wants to throw. He's being rushed. This pass was intended for Lacey. He got tangled up in the chain on the near side of the field. Hopefully he's all right.
Carlo over there defending on the play. Got to give Ast a lot of credit, Ray. He sure is cool, and even when he's completed a lot of passes, you turn around and you look back downfield behind the line of scrimmage, and there he is picking himself up off the turf.
Ast 6 of 12 for 37 yards tonight through the air. He has run the ball club well. Second and 10 from the Cowboy 38. Ast rolls right, looks over the middle. The ball is almost intercepted by Chris Rockins.
Well, you can see that coming from up here. Kirk Phillips, the intended receiver, running a post pattern. Rockins playing it just like he should, timed it perfectly and stepped in front. Almost had it. You can see he sniffed this one out. Just off the fingertips. Had a good shot at it.
Carl Lowe, the man coming up on the right side of your picture to belt the receiver. Ball was intended for Kirk Phillips. That'll bring up third and 10. See if the Cowboy defense coming with a blitz. Option play to Ast. He's going to be stopped after a pickup of three. It'll bring up a fourth down situation. Possible field goal attempt by Stu Crum. Boy, he can hit it from that distance, believe me. He has one 50-yarder to his credit tonight, and he and the kicking team come on the field. The Cowboy defense has done their job.
Well, Stu Crum has kicked one from 30, one from 50.
This is a straight shot from the middle of the field. This will be a 52-yard attempt. The kick is up. It is no good. Off to the left side of the Cowboy defense holes and will take over with excellent field position. Time remaining, 2:19 left in the third period. Tulsa leading 12-7. I can hear some of the coaches in the booth to our left. I don't know which group it is. They're upset about something. I'm not sure about what. So the Cowboys will go to work at their own 38. What they're yelling about over here was that one of the teams might have had 12 men on the field, possibly Oklahoma State.
Well, I don't know, whatever it is, we did not see a flag thrown, but down on the field, you can see the blue-shirted Tulsa Hurricane jumping up and down. Maybe one was thrown, and the officials are discussing it now.
Charlie, did you ever see a penalty marker?
I haven't seen one.
I have not seen a penalty marker yet.
Now, the officials now pointed in the direction of OSU, so looks like the Cowboys will get the football, whatever the discussion was about. But we'll have it in pretty good shape at their own 37-yard line.
Well, an indication, the way that Tulsa was bouncing around, that the penalty had been assessed. We never saw a flag, but it will be OSU's football. I guess it just goes unnoticed. I'm not an official, so, and I don't like to get into the officiating of a ball game. Two minutes, 19 seconds, our time remaining in the third period. OSU has not led in this ball game. The Cowboys have not led. They trail 12-7. Jimmy Johnson talking things over with one of his assistant coaches on the sideline. And the Cowboys will put it into play. First and 10 at their own 38-yard line. Hines wants to throw on first down. Looking. He's going to go deep. The ball is intercepted, I believe, back at the Tulsa 25-yard line.
Nope.
They say it belongs to OSU.
When a defender and an offensive player catch the football simultaneously, then the catch goes to the offensive man, and that is just what happened.
John, what we have to see is the battle that went on between the OSU receiver and the defender back there. There was an awful lot of bumping going on. We'll take another look at it. Adam Hines didn't get enough on it. The ball was underthrown, a 54-yard completion. Watch the bumping going on here. This is what we're talking about. And the OSU man, Terry Young, steps up front. It'll be first down TU, rather first down OSU at the Tulsa 24. Hines gives to Anderson, right side, trying to slide outside. He's going to be corralled over there and dropped for a gain of one.
Here's a look at it again. It actually looked like number 42, Morrow, hit Young before the ball got there, but at any rate, it was a what they call a simultaneous catch, and we already went over that the offensive man, of course, is awarded the football. Great, great effort, though, by Terry Young.
On first down, Ernest Anderson did not pick up anything, was stopped at the line of scrimmage. So the Cowpokes will look at things, second and 10. Ball on the far hash mark. Hines, play action, coming this way. Throws, got a man wide open. It is complete to James Evans. Evans inside the 10, down to the 6-yard line. Cliff Abbott defending on the play for TU. But John, give a lot of credit to the Tulsa, or make that the OSU offensive line. Hines had all day to throw it.
He did a great job. The little fake to Anderson, which will freeze the linebackers momentarily. And James Evans just finding the seam. And Hines delivering a nice pass. Evans gets inside the 10-yard line, down to about the 7th. First down, Cowboys.
I could have sworn I saw a Frisbee laying on the field on the replay. First and goal to go for OSU at the Tulsa 7. Anderson gets the call right side to the 5, and he's going to be pushed back there. The left side of the Tulsa defensive line on the stop.
John Cooper on the stop coming up from the secondary that time.
Adam Hines, 10 of 18, 147 yards. Talking about numbers, the biggest numbers of the night are right out on the field. It is second down and 4.
We probably saw the last play of the third quarter, 7 seconds left to go. I doubt if the Cowboys will get it off in time.
I stand to be corrected. It is second and goal to go for the Cowboys. Clock ticks away, and that's the end of the third period. And here at Skelly Stadium, our score at the end of 3, as the Tulsa Golden Hurricane 12 and the Oklahoma State Cowboys 7. We'll be back with the final period. Questionable calls in the third period left a lot of people wondering. The Cowboys felt that Ernest Anderson had been interfered with on a pass play that would have been an automatic first down. They didn't get the call. Tulsa missed a 52-yard field goal, and everyone said that OSU had 12 men on the field. That call was missed. The crowd on its feet. Second and goal from the four. Young in motion to the left. Quick pitch to Anderson. Inside, down to the 2-yard line. It'll be third and two. Cliff Abbott comes up from the linebacker spot to make the stop. John, we won't see a field goal attempt. We'll see OSU with two tries at getting into the end zone.
Cowboy rushing offense. Total of 122 yards after that last carry by Ernest Anderson, who has gotten a workout tonight.
We'll find out what the Cowboys have up their sleeve here. They are faced with third and goal to goal. Make it from the three. Former in motion. Quick pitch. Anderson up the middle. Anderson. Touchdown, Oklahoma State.
No question about who the Cowboys would go to. Ernest Anderson from 2 yards out. Cowboys now have a 13-12 lead.
We'll take two different looks at it. Ernest Anderson.
Good
he bounced, John, and I'm not sure if he got over there.
He didn't get over. I didn't think he did, but.
Well, I didn't either.
Well, I guess maybe that's a break they got in favor of the one that went against him on the push against Ernest Anderson on the pass play. But he was short of the goal line. We'll take it.
Let's see what the Cowboys do, John. See if they go for two. OSU will go for two. They lead it 13-12. You got to think about that field goal. Hines in trouble. Rolls. He throws over the middle. John Chesley complete.
Well, I'll tell you, Ray, I'd like to see that again. I thought Chesley pushed off. I thought he had his right arm holding the defender away, but a great catch by John Chesley and good patience by Adam Hines.
The Cowboys are on top, 15-12, and the crowd is rocking at Scully Stadium. Let's take a look. Chesley had position.
I don't think we'll be able to.
Between the defensive man and the receiver. Let's see.
You couldn't see it there, but a great catch by Chesley and great concentration as Beasley had his hand right in his face, but John Chesley gives the Cowboys a 3-point lead, 15-12, and we'll be back with more action at Scully Stadium right after this.
The touchdown run by Ernest Anderson. We were trying to debate whether or not he got into the end zone. You be the judge yourself.
No question
about it, John. He was about a half a yard short of it.
Yep.
Kevin Goffrey, a sophomore from Ponca City, will tee it up. Great fan participation. This is what college athletics are all about. Super crowd on hand here at Scully Stadium tonight, no matter what the outcome might be. But the Cowboys went for two, and they lead it 15-12, so a field goal won't do anything but tie it. 14-17, time remaining. Godfrey, great kick. Lacey can't handle it. He'll down at the end zone. Touchback. We'll see what the OSU defense can do now. Be interesting to read the newspapers tomorrow, John, to see what the head coaches have to say about some of the officiating.
Now, of course, we were able to see that touchdown run by Anderson in slow motion, which helps. Sometimes the officials, when they have to see it at normal speed, it's kind of hard to judge sometimes, but he was short.
We were talking about the soccer markings on the field, and that's right there by the goal line. That could have been a mix-up there. First down, the give is DeLacy up the middle. He gets 2 or 3 yards. Tough running in the middle of the OSU defense. Mike Green gets up off the bottom of the pile. Gary Lewis and Gary Sachery also in on the tackle. Gary Woods comes out of the ball game for Tulsa. Keith Estes put wide to the near side. Also a wide out to the right. Second and seven. Estes in trouble. He's going to be dropped for a loss back at the 16-yard line.
Number 42, Rodney Harding got in there and got him first, but it was Gary Lewis who put Skip Ast down. Cowboys coming hard that time.
Here's another look at it. You'll find out exactly what the quarterback's saying. Gary Lewis breathing down his neck.
42,
Harding came in from the defensive end spot, John, to turn the play in and make the big play. There's a loss of 6 on the play. It is 3rd and 13. Clock continues to run. 13-10, our time remaining. OSU leading 15-12. Here's a draw play to Lacey. Plenty of running room. Gunner make it. Michael Gunner across the 40 to make first down. Fooled everybody.
Chris Rockins on the stop, but big play for Tulsa. First down.
Boy, the middle of that TU offensive line did the job that time. Himes, Cox, Kaspersky. Jimmy Johnson looking on in disbelief. Attendance tonight, 35,297, fourth largest in Skelly Stadium history. Big first down for the Golden Hurricane. The gives to Lacey. He's got a big hole up front, and he's into OSU territory, down to the Cowboy, 46.
Should be another Tulsa first down. Two big plays after the Cowboys. And the Golden Hurricane, 3rd and 13.
Pearson and Kapersky up front. They open the hole. Lots of running room.
Mike Green, 68, missing the tackle. Finally, Brent Guy and Chris Rockins making the stop.
Cowboys are going to have to stay at home on defense. It's Lacey again. He gets good yardage, maybe 4 or 5. Mike Green made the stop.
And Lacey almost running over Green. Lacey running exceptionally hard.
Give credit to the Golden Hurricane. They have played one tremendous football game tonight. Lacey, 15 carries, 74 yards. He's been the Hurricane workhorse. Picked up 5 on first down. Gunner gets the call this time. Cuts back against the grain, still on his feet. He's going to go all the way.
41 yards. Michael Gunner, who is a threat to go all the way from anywhere on the field. Got some great blocking from the left side of that Tulsa line. Cowboys find themselves trailing 18-15.
Listen to the crowd. We know there are a lot of Oklahoma State fans here tonight, but believe me, these Tulsa fans are rooting hard for their ball club. And they came roaring back. Give an awful lot of credit to the offensive line for TU. Gunner made the cut back across the grain, and it was clear sailing. Few crumbs, extra point is good. And we've got 11 minutes and 41 seconds left. A lot of exciting football. We're rocking back and forth, and now the Hurricane are back on top. They lead it 19-15. We'll be back with more fourth period action from Skelly Stadium after these words. Hurricane marched right down the field, and they did it right through the middle. Did not put the ball in the air. The Tulsa players wanting the fans on their feet. This ball game tonight, here's a look at the touchdown run. Watch Michael Gunner, the great balance he has. Fluid motion, cuts back against the grain, picks up a good block. Carl Lowe, the last man there, did not know he even had the football. Brent Guy gives chase, but it's too late. Gunner, 41 yards and a touchdown. The extra point by Stu Crum was good. And Tulsa leads the Cowboys by a score of 19-15. Stu Crum will kick it off back deep for the Cowboys. It'll be Harry Roberts, Jim Evans, and Ken Zachary. Crowd on its feet. Crum boots it deep. Evans takes it out of the end zone, and the Cowboys are 80 yards away from pay dirt.
It was all Tulsa in the first half, leading 12-0 at halftime. OSU coming back in the third quarter and early in the fourth quarter take the lead, but the Hurricane have it now 19-15. Great ball game.
Fans across the nation getting a chance to see this ball game tonight, courtesy of WTBS. Both the coaches love that idea from a recruiting standpoint. The Cowboys have their work cut out, 11:41. Left in the ball game. Anderson gets the call. Hard-nosed football. Bjorkman makes the stop. Anderson, a pickup of 3. He'll be second and seven. Scoreboard says six. We'll go with that. Evans comes in from the bench with a play.
John Cooper, the Tulsa head coach, pacing the sidelines, watching his defense.
Had a chance to watch Tulsa in the ball game against Air Force. They came back strong in the second half. They're an outstanding football team. Anderson gets the call, tries to slide to the outside, has the first down and a little bit more.
Nate Harris making the stop. Just like Gunter is a threat to go all the way for Tulsa, Ernest Anderson, very much a threat from any spot on the field for OSU, and that's a Cowboy first down.
That's the entire story in front of you. 19-15, Tulsa leading, 10-58 left in the ballgame. Rodney Hayes has checked in at fullback for the first time tonight. Be leading the way for Ernest Anderson. Terry Young, one of the wide receivers. He and Cromer will be split wide left. Hines, a quarterback. He wants to throw, play action. He's got Chesley going deep. He underthrows him to Terry Young. Young has it into TU territory down at the 43-yard line. So the decoy was John Chesley, the big tight end. John was chugging straight down the field, and they threw underneath.
Good pattern. He was looking for Young, who, as you mentioned, Ray, was running an out cut underneath Chesley as they ran the tight end up that far sideline, or near the far sideline, to clear it out. Terry Young was open, and the Cowboys on the move.
Ryan Burroughs made the last stop for TU at his first down, OSU. Hines rolls right, wants to throw again. A down and out pattern is complete to Young. Young to the 25, to the 23, 21-yard line. The TU defensive back decided to gamble and go for the interception. Jesse Morrow couldn't come up with a football. We have seen some offense, John, in the last 4 or 5 minutes.
Certainly have. The Cowboys rolling out. Adam Hines delivering a strike to Young. Morrow trying for the interception. Couldn't get it. Good move here by Young to get some extra yardage. Dips to the outside, back to the inside. Actually, that was Morrow who missed the tackle. First down.
Hines gives to Anderson, hurdles over one tackler down to the 25. Make that the 15.
Well, at the rate these two teams are going, whoever touches the football last might win. And we both teams are moving on offense. Albert Myers to make the stop on that last play, but a good pickup by Anderson.
A gain of six. It is second and four for the Cowboys. That's what gives coaches gray hairs. And pardon me, I know it doesn't do wonders for the fans either. Clock ticking away, 9:15, plenty of time left. Hines to Anderson again, and the TU defense smells that one out perfectly. Leading the way, Brian Burrow.
And it was number 47, Brian Burroughs, helping up Anderson there, who made the penetration and actually stuffed the play.
A loss of a yard on the play. It is now third and five. Jimmy Johnson wants to talk things over with Adam Hines, and while he does that, we'll give you a recap of what happened in the Big 8 over the weekend if you haven't heard already. It was a great day for Big 8 football. Colorado, because when play resumes, it'll be third and five for OSU. The ball, I can't find. There are a couple of
she might know where it is.
Those are, I don't think she can see very much out of those. At least I hope not. The ball rests on the TU 16-yard line. Third and five. Evans in motion. The give to the other side is Anderson. Anderson with a first down as he runs over a man. He is down to the 6-yard line.
Yeah, there'll be a penalty, a late hit. Anderson was down on the ground. I could see the official trying to jerk the flag out of his pocket. That will move at about the half distance to the goal line from there.
John, you are always talking about the power of Ernest Anderson. We'll see it coming up here in a minute, maybe. He ran over somebody.
Here it is again, a look through the TU backfield from where the safety would be. Burroughs gets caught up. He's blocked out of there. The Tulsa linebacker, some good blocking up front. Anderson right here runs right over. Defensive back, he'll go down, keep rolling it. There's a piling on right there.
Britt Dennis at 5'8", 170 pounds. Ernest Anderson at 5'11", 195 pounds. We'll take a look at it another angle. Great blocking up front by the OSU offensive line. Rodney Hayes, the fullback, took one man out. There's the late hit. And it is first and goal to go for the Cowboys.
68, Carl Pendleton on the late hit. The fellow that Anderson ran over was Brent Dennis, and we have a timeout. That'll give the Cowboys just one timeout left, I believe. Yeah, they're down to one now. I'm sure Jimmy Johnson wants to make sure, though, Ray, now that the Cowboys are this close, that everybody knows exactly what they're going to run and how they're going to do it.
If you haven't gotten your tickets to the Cowboy games this year, you still got plenty of time to do so. We'll be on the road next Saturday night in Louisville, Kentucky. Game time is 7 o'clock Louisville time. After that, the Cowboys are open on the 2nd of October. Then on the 9th, they'll be in Stillwater against Kansas. That'll be Parents' Day. The 16th, it'll be Colorado coming to town. That is homecoming for the Cowpokes. On the 23rd, they'll travel to Norman to take on the OU Sooners. Then on October the 30th, Missouri will be at Stillwater. The 6th of November, a big date to mark on your calendar. That's when the Cowpokes head up to Lincoln to take on Nebraska. November the 13th, we'll take on K-State at Manhattan. Then on the 20th, the Cowboys close out their home season against Iowa State. That is Youth Day at Stillwater, an afternoon game. And then the Saturday after Thanksgiving, we'll all be on the road and head out to sunny California, San Diego State, to take on the Aztecs, who have not gotten off to an outstanding start. In the meantime, back to action here at Scully Stadium. A series of big plays for the Cowboys. They have first and goal to go at the TU 3-yard line. The Cowboys have talked it over. 8:45 left. They trail by four, 19-15. Hang on to the football. The crowd on its feet. Out of the pro set, the first time we've seen that from the Cowpokes. Adam Hines on the keeper, down the right side. He is hit, falls forward to the two, maybe the one. The first time this year we have seen the Cowboys out of the pro set, John.
Jimmy Johnson deciding what set his Cowboys will use on this next play as he sends Mark Cromer in. Now, if you can figure that out, you tell me, Ray.
Said right tight, Jet 54, whatever that is. That's great, great work by the audio man. Blankenship made the last stop. The Cowboys out of the I formation. Cromer, the man in motion, coming to the wide side. The gives to Anderson. Anderson up the middle. He is short of the goal line. He is down to about the half-foot mark.
Well, Jimmy, what are we going to do now?
The Cowboys, with one timeout remaining, the Hurricane have three. But if you don't punch it in from here, you won't have to worry about timeouts.
Ernest Anderson on that last carry, trying to find a hole. See, he almost got in. Burroughs made the stop, just shy of the goal line.
The Cowboys with two shots at it. Rodney Hayes turns around to Anderson and asks what the count was. Young in motion. They give to Anderson up the middle.
All depends if they stop his forward progress. The officials have not done anything yet. They're going to mark it shy of the goal line.
Boy, what a lick. Tulsa playing great defense tonight. I tell you, I am still wondering how Arkansas beat them 38-0. That defense is fired up. Here it is, the ball game riding on the line, possibly. Clock running, 6:57 left. John Cooper and his staff looking on for the sideline. The crowd comes to its feet. It is fourth and goal to go for the Cowboys from the one. Out of the eye. Cromer in motion. Anderson, the deep man. He gets the call, and he's going to be stopped.
I don't think he made it.
He is stopped. Great defensive stand by the Tulsa Golden Hurricane.
6:40 left to go in the fourth quarter. Still plenty of time for the Cowboys, but remember, they have only one timeout left. They must stop the Hurricane now.
It is up to the Cowboy defense to hold Tulsa deep in their own territory. The Cowpokes went to the well once too often. Look at this, great penetration.
Carl Pendleton, number 68, was right there waiting for Ernest, who really never had a chance. Another look at it again. Blue shirts, though, right there.
One of the great moments in college football, the goal line stand. Flags on the play, TU in motion. Gosh, they can't be penalized much. Remember the last time that the Golden Hurricane did not have good field position? It was on a third down play, long yardage. They went with a draw play and got it out to midfield. That broke the Cowboys back as Tulsa went on in and scored. The linebackers have to stay home here.
Looks like it will be against Tulsa.
They're probably declined that, John.
I don't know if they'll get a chance, really, on a...
Well, they won't.
It's going to be an automatic walk-off, which is really too bad, because I think if they had the option, they would have declined it. There really was no gain on the play.
Out of the end zone. Tulsa looking at 99 yards. Green turf in front of them. First and 11. Pass wants to throw out of his own end zone. He's in trouble. Throws over the middle. The ball is almost intercepted into the arms. And it's a foot race. Greg Hill's going to haul him down from behind. But, oh, what a chain of events. Keith Estes, the pass was intended for him. Somebody stepped in front of him and deflected the football, went for the interception, went right into Estes' arms. It was a foot race. Greg Hill hauled him down from behind. A gain of 80 yards.
Looked like an OSU secondary man had the ball, and Estes just took it right away. Judge for yourself. I thought it might have been 37 Rockins. Nope, somebody in front, 45 for OSU, who is Raymond Polk, and Estes just took it right away. Hill finally making the tackle, but a big play for Tulsa.
First down at the Cowboy 20. The give is to Lacey up the middle. He picks up maybe three. Oh, what a chain of events. The Cowboys were knocking on the door, had fourth and goal to go for the one, couldn't get it in, and Tulsa turned right back around. Here it is again, a different angle. Ass throwing out of the end zone. Raymond Polk had it. Estes hauls it in. And then there you see the foot race. Raymond Polk must have great speed. After going the other way, he came back and almost caught it. It is second and seven. Long count. The give is to the first man through. Number 16, Eddie Hamilton, seeing his first action of the night. Mike Green made the stop.
5 minutes, 35 seconds left to go. Clock running. OSU with one timeout left. Ray, if OSU loses this game tonight, we hope they can turn it around here and win this thing. You'd have to say that turnovers and giving up the big play have hurt them. They had TU 13 way back in their own territory, and Gunner broke the long timeout now by Tulsa, but Gunner broke the long draw play, and this play that passed to Estes just seconds ago.
This has been a great college football game. I hope you've had a chance to join us for the entire telecast tonight. We'll be back Saturday night for the telecast of the OSU, the delayed telecast, I guess I should say, of OSU and Louisville. Tulsa wants a timeout. Skip Ass comes over and talks with John Cooper. They are faced with a third and five situation. Here's where we stand right now. The Golden Hurricane on top of OSU by a score of 19-15. And they are thinking right here, if they don't make a first down here, they'll go for the field goal. That would make it 22-15. And then put the Cowboys in the position. If they did get the touchdown, they'd have to go for two to tie it.
Number 11, OSU secondary man Greg Hill, you saw a few minutes ago.
Kirk Phillips came out of the ball game for a second. He'll go back in. He's the leading receiver on the night. He'll replace David Hersey. The ball in the middle of the field. The OSU defense. Mike Green patting everybody on the back. He and James Spencer saying, come on, guys, you got a hole right here. Great college football game. First Sunday night game. Skip Ass still confused as to what to do. He's done a super job tonight running the offense for Tulsa. Made the big play when he's had to. John Cooper kneels down, looking at his other coaches, talking things over. Tulsa, co-champions of the Missouri Valley a year ago. They are picked to win it again this year. Third and five from the pro set. The running backs are Gunner and Lacey. The pitch back comes to Gunner, and he's going to be stopped, piled up. At the 16-yard line, Chris Rockins made the initial hit. Gunner had a great night, 240 yards against Air Force. He has not had that kind of night tonight, although he did have a 41-yard carry. He has picked up 81 yards on the night, so that was the largest portion of that.
41 of those on that touchdown run in the fourth quarter.
Stu Crum is on. He'll spot the tee at the 20. It'll be a chip shot for him, a 30-yarder. We told you the situation a moment ago. If he makes the field goal, the Cowboys will trail. The kick is up, and it is true. So the Hurricane rocked back on top. They were still on top, but they now lead it by a score of 22-15. So with a touchdown and the extra point, OSU, John, I was wrong a moment ago, OSU could tie it and then have to go for two to get the win.
And I'm sure if it got to that situation, Jimmy Johnson would go for the win. Still plenty of time, but the Cowboys, with only one timeout left, Tulsa has two. 4:36 to go. Still plenty of time for the Cowboys to score.
Those are a lot of ifs. 4:36 remaining, and it makes it awful tough. Steve Crum coming off the field. That was a big extra point, and he knew it. 22-15 our score. Tulsa on top. If you recall, a year ago, the score between these two teams, OSU won at 23-21. Right now, it looks the best they could do is win at 23-22. Maybe wishful thinking. Stu Crum will tee it up. You can almost bet the way his adrenaline is flowing that he may kick it over into the athletic dormitory. Crum's kick drives Evans back deep into the end zone. He decides, after looking like he might come out with it, to down it. And the Cowpokes are 80 yards away. One timeout remaining, 4:36. Tulsa with two timeouts. It'll be first and 10 at the 20. Adam Hines has done an outstanding job here in the second half. Mike Knoll, the Tulsa defensive coordinator. Boy, he's got to be proud of his kids tonight. They have put up one heck of a fight. They made a great goal line stand. They won't forget that one for a long time in this city or around the state. Young split wide to the right, Cromer to the left. Hines throwing on first down. He wants it all back in a hurry. His pass is caught. Oh, great over-the-shoulder catch by Terry Young.
Oh, this has been some kind of ball game. Terry Young and a great throw by Adam Hines, but was he out of bounds? They're walking all the way back downfield. I don't see a flag. We'll have to wait and see. Apparently it was.
Gosh, I must be getting blind in my old age.
He was close to the sidelines. Nope. Fisher right there says no.
Said he didn't catch it? Oh. Add that to the list. 4 minutes, 28 seconds remaining. It is second and 10. The Cowboys went for broke on first down. Hines over the middle. Has a man open. He overthrows Mark Cromer. It is intercepted by John Cooper. Cooper back to the 25, the 23. Oh, that may be all she wrote for OSU, and Tulsa celebrating down on the sideline. When you get in a definite passing down, John, it changes the complexion of things.
Certainly no need for the Cowboys to go for the long pass, although if it's there, you should try to hit the fella. Adam Hines just didn't deliver it. Anderson.
His third interception of the night. He just overthrew him. He had Mark Cromer wide open over the middle.
Yep, just threw it a little bit too high and behind him, and John Cooper was there to pick it off. Look from the end zone camera. See, Cromer was open, but Cooper was right there and picked it off.
Cowboy defense looking for the turnover. Tulsa with two timeouts left. They won't do anything fancy here. Skip Aston on the option play, elects to keep it. Comes down the left side. Tulsa pom-pom girls waving to the fans across the country. John Fossen will work him his way down along the sidelines, hopefully for a visit with Jimmy Johnson. Great college football game tonight. Both of these teams have shown me an awful lot. Second down and nine. The Cowboys only have one timeout remaining. Keep in mind, Tulsa most definitely in field goal range. Skip passed on a keeper. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, the initial line of scrimmage. Mike Green made the stop. And Tulsa is being safe with the football. They're keeping it right in the middle of the field for Stu Crum to put this thing out of reach, possibly. The Cowboys would like a turnover. Gary Woods in from the bench with a play. Tulsa wins this one. We'll have to give them a lot of credit for bouncing back the way they did. Skip pass. They just keep it in the middle of the field, looking for Stu Crum, and he'll come on. Keep in mind, we have had a couple of block field goals or a couple of missed field goals, a blocked field goal in this ball game. The chanting you hear is not booze, but stew, stew for Stu Crum as he comes on. Scott Brown, backup quarterback, will hold. A lot of people overlook that important aspect of the kicking game. This is a 35-yarder. The snap's good. The kick is up. It is good. That ball floated like a butterfly. I didn't think it would ever get there. But it was through the uprights, and Stu Crum has bounced back from his horrible opening game to put the Hurricane on top, 25-15. It would take some kind of a miracle for the Cowboys to pull this one out of the fire. Some people say this is not a rivalry. You can't tell it by watching the fans here at Skelly Stadium. Here it is from the end zone. The ball finally came back into the atmosphere. Stu Crum has just set a new TU record for four field goals in a single game. Time remaining, 2:24. The Cowboys used a couple of timeouts when they had first and goal to goal and didn't make it. The Hurricanes stopped them in four downs. That was the key, no matter what you might say about this ball game. And then Tulsa came right back at second down at their own one-yard line and came up with an 80-yard pass play. Evans will come out with it. Oh, not a smart play at all. He gets to the outside. He may go all the way. Evans still on his feet across the 30, knocked forward to the 37-yard line. He lulled everybody asleep. He hesitated. He said, what the heck? I think I'll come with it. But the thing you had to keep in mind that may have upset the coaches more so than anything else was the time that elapsed off the clock when he ran the football instead of downing it, starting at the 20. Tulsa on top by 10, 25-15. Great college football game, no matter who you might have been for. Ike Jackson, the new quarterback for OSU, he's going to go over the middle, and this one is picked off. Back to the 42-yard line, Bob Babbage. The Tulsa secondary, the linebackers, have done a great job tonight. The Cowboy quarterbacks have not had that much pressure put on them. They just haven't been on the mark. They were in the third period, and that's when they got back in the football game. There's a look at it, what Ike Jackson was looking at. Ball was just not thrown well. If he had thrown it to the outside, it would have been complete. Two minutes, 6 seconds left. Tulsa would like to run out the clock here and should be able to do so. Thanks to our spotters tonight, Cam and Charlie Wilson, Doug Crane, our statistician, who said John Fossen down on the sideline. Delay of game penalty should be marked off against the Hurricane. What a football game this has been, and you have to give an awful lot of credit to TU. They were sky high coming into this one, and they had worked hard all week. All week after their 38-0 loss to Arkansas. could be a very valuable lesson for the Cowpokes, who don't head into Big 8 play until the 9th of October. Skip passed on a keeper around the left side. He'll be piled up at the 44. Clock ticks away, very valuable seconds. If you're an OSU fan, it's going 90 miles an hour. If you're a TU fan, it won't run fast enough. Jimmy Johnson, an objected Jimmy Johnson. Pat Jones looking on from the far sideline. This has been a game of inches. Passed on the quarterback keeper. Just trying to run out the clock. The Cowboys had fourth and goal from the one and didn't make it. Tulsa turned around from their own one-yard line. Ass dropped back in the end zone, threw over the middle, went in and out of the arms of defensive back Raymond Polk. Estes caught it and raced 80 yards with it. That has been the thing that turned this football game upside down. 55-54. Cowboys on the road next week. Be heading to Louisville, Kentucky to take on the Louisville Cardinals. Do a lot of credit to John Cooper and his young ball club. They've done a super job tonight. Tulsa has an open date next week. After that, they catch Kansas on October the 2nd in Lawrence. Very disappointing loss for Oklahoma State. 45 seconds left. The Cowboys with only a timeout remaining. They could stop the clock. This is third and 16. Asked on a quarterback sneak. I don't think we will see Stu Crum. That possibility exists that you could block it, pick it up, and run it back. And after that, anything could happen. The Cowboys used their last timeout. The Tulsa offense coming over to the sideline. Gosh, are they a bunch of happy guys. We just seen a shot of a dejected Jimmy Johnson, and what a class guy he is. The Tulsa coaching staff done a great job of preparing their team for this ball game. One that the fans that have been here tonight won't forget for a long, long time. We had a great second half. Helen Cooper, the head coach's wife and her daughter, for the second time tonight, I believe, Doug, you correct me if I am wrong, Steve Cook is on to punt. All he wants to do is get this one away. He's not worried about how far it goes. Fair catch is called for. The ball hits at the OSU 7-yard line and rolls in and out of the end zone. So the Cowboys will get one more shot at it from their own 20. OSU out of timeout, so they have no way of stopping the clock. John Cooper and family, all he needs to do is get his son, the safety, to run over from the middle of the field right now, and they have a family portrait. 27 seconds out of time remaining. Ike Jackson, the quarterback for OSU. There's a pass out of the flat for Chesley. He steps out of bounds with it at the 30. If you're going to lose one early, lose it before you get into conference play. That's the only theory that the Cowboys can go by right now. Take nothing away from Tulsa, the Golden Hurricane, an excellent football team. They have done a terrific job tonight. They lead it 25-15, 22 seconds remaining. This could be the final play of the game. Jackson in a lot of trouble, rolling right, throws. Pass was intended for Chesley and almost picked off again by John Cooper Jr. That's a very interesting story, father and son. If you were keeping up with the national events over the weekend, John Elway at Stanford played his father's team, San Jose State, much smaller school, and San Jose State won the ball game. John Cooper has his son on his team, and nobody can question his ability. He's done an outstanding job back at the free safety spot. 15 seconds left. Jackson straight back, drops it in the flat to Anderson. Anderson is from running room. Anderson across the 45, out to the 46-yard line, and that should just about do it. The clock should stop on the first down, though. I want to thank all of you for watching this evening. We'll be back Saturday night. That's right, this coming Saturday night at 10:35. Jackson backs out from under center before he gets the football. Looks like the 4th of July, the air full of flags. That'll stop the clock with just 2 seconds remaining in the ball game. It's been a great college football game. John Fossen down on the sidelines, hopefully with some closing comments for us. TU fans are still hanging on. Believe me, they are still chanting, TU, TU. I know they're looking forward to the basketball season also. Nolan Richardson, the head coach, they were in the top 10 a year ago. Upset the regional playoffs by Houston, who went on to be in the Final Four. John Cooper running out on the field. I don't know what he was trying to get the officials' attention about. Jackson wants to go deep, pumps about 3 times. Now he's going to throw it. He does, and it should be picked off. It is. Kelly Beasley lays back, has it, goes out of bounds. I believe it might have been Beasley. But just the same, the ball game is over. Our final score here at Skelly Stadium tonight is the Tulsa Golden Hurricane 25, the Cowboys of OSU 15. We'll be back with some closing comments from hopefully head coach Jimmy Johnson right after these final messages. What are we going to do here? John Foston with a very dejected Jimmy Johnson.
Jimmy, a tough loss, but I got to give your ball club a lot of credit. Down 12-0 at halftime, you almost pulled it out.
Well, we made too many mistakes. We played very poorly. We did not play the kicking game well. We did not play offense well. We did not play defense well. You got to give Tulsa credit. They did a fantastic job. They had great emotion. They executed on offense. They kept the ball away from our offense. And their defense rose to the occasion when they had to. They got the turnovers.
I know you were concerned about turnovers. Last week you had quite a few against North Texas State. That hurt tonight in giving up the big play. Other than that, you played pretty well.
Well, we didn't play well enough. We made more mistakes in this ball game than maybe any ball game I've been around in the last couple of years.
I know you've got the Louisville Cardinals next weekend. Let's get it cranked up and go out there and get them. Jimmy, thanks for stopping by. Jimmy Johnson, the head coach of the OSU Cowboys. Now let's go back upstairs to Ray Tucker.
Thank you, John. Our final score once again, the Tulsa Golden Hurricane 25, the Cowboys of Oklahoma State 15. So the Cowboys go back to the drawing board. They'll be looking for a win next week in Louisville. We hope you enjoy this evening's telecast. Until next Saturday night, I'm Ray Tucker for John Foss and the entire kitchen.